Check it out. Used to drop acid and flick through these for hours, man.
Really? A book on tape?
Still a book.
Hello. You're listening to another edition of American Psychopaths. Chapter 57, The Saint of Killers. Our story begins in 1861. Our backdrop, the American Civil War. Before he was a myth, our subject was a man fighting for the Confederate Army. Some called him heartless, others insane. His compatriots dubbed him the Butcher of Gettysburg. But all wars come to an end, until one day, as fate would have it, he fell in love. She hailed from Laredo, a Christian girl of German descent. It wasn't long till they were wed, and sooner still, she gave him a daughter. And for a time, the cowboy was at peace. But fortune favors the wind. The cowboy lost his wife and daughter to disease. Legend says that in that moment, his soul shattered into a million pieces, scattering to the four corners of the earth. Hate became the blood coursing through his veins. The only living man without a soul. On that fateful day, the cowboy became the grim, taciturn, implacable killing machine known commonly as the Saint of Killers. But our story doesn't end here. The saint sought bloody revenge on the town of Ratwater. Dying there in the famous tornado of 1881. But soulless men have no place in paradise. And God banished him to the netherworld, imprisoned and forced to relive his most injurious memory over and over and over again. It's there he rots, the most hated man in heaven, the most dreaded in hell, rumored to be feared by Satan himself. We hope you enjoyed this edition of American Psychopaths. Join us next time for Chapter 58, Dick Cheney.